All right, this is fifth grade, module 3, lesson 12. We're going to continue subtracting fractions. What's different in this lesson is, in the olden days, we would have called it borrowing. We're going to have to do some borrowing in this. But I love Engage New York because it really gives students a choice of choosing a variety of methods, and because the whole point is not necessarily to get the right answer. The first point, the priority, is to make sure students understand what's going on, and then we're going to get the answer right. Otherwise, we just are going to have students memorizing fractions, and they don't understand why it works, and then they're going to move on to high school, and everybody's going to complain because kids don't know fractions. So I love this lesson because the emphasis is on providing students with a variety of methods for subtracting fractions. Let's get going. So I'm going to show probably three different ways to subtract this problem. So the first one, I'm going to start with way over here. I'm going to put 3 1/4 minus 2 1/3. And so one thing that we can do is we can pretend that this is really 3 + 1/4 and then minus 2 1/3. Now we can take the 3 and subtract 2 1/3. And I think fifth graders can do that with some effort, but they'll be able to do it and get 3 - 2 1/3 is going to equal 2/3. So that equals 2/3, plus we still have this 1/4 sitting here. So now what started out as a subtraction problem is now an addition problem. So 2/3 plus 1/4. So I'm going to get our common unit, or our common denominator. In this case, it's going to be 12. So how do you turn thirds into twelfths? By multiplying by 4, which means you multiply the 2 by 4, and we get 8. Similarly, how do you turn fourths into twelfths? Well, you multiply by 3, which means we're going to multiply the numerator by 3. And then 1 times 3 is 3, and we add together, and we get 11/12, and there's our answer. So that's one way to do it. Now, by the way, if we wanted to, we can show what that would look like on the number line. What that would look like on the number line is we'd start out at 3, and then because we subtracted by 2 1/3, we'd go backwards by 2 1/3, and that's going to put us at 2/3, right here, 2/3, and then because we really started at 3 and we went backwards 2 1/3, now we have to add up, and I'm going to zoom in here because I can, we're going to add up by 1/4. Add up by 1/4, and so the answer is going to be right here, and that answer is going to be whatever we get when we take 2/3 and add 1/4. Now I'm going to zoom out, and we see, that's exactly what we did. So we subtracted, and then we ended up having to do 2/3 plus 1/4. That's because we pretended to start at 3 and then we subtracted, but then we have to add in that 1/4 because we temporarily ignored it. Kind of like what we did here. We temporarily ignored the 1/4. Now another way we could have done this is we could have started with, let's write 3 1/4 minus 2 1/3. Another way we could have done this is we could have just subtracted the whole numbers, and we could have gotten 1 1/4 minus 1/3. Now that we've got that, now we need to get a common denominator, and this is going to be a little bit different from the Engage New York teacher notes. We're going to get a common denominator, which in this case is 12. And so our whole number is still our whole number, but our denominator is going to become 12. So just like in the, I think in the previous problem, yeah. So we did 4 times 3 to get 4 times 3 to get 12. So we're going to do 1 times 3 to get 3. And then 3 in our denominator times 4 gives us 12. So 1 times 4 gives us 4. Now, students are going to notice, oh, wait a second. We have 3 twelfths, and we're supposed to take away 4 twelfths. We don't have enough twelfths to take away 4 twelfths. So what we're going to do is we're going to take advantage of the fact that 1 is really 12 twelfths. So that means 1 and 3 twelfths is really, can be written as 15 twelfths minus 4 twelfths. So if you need to, pause the video and watch that and look at this screen to see how I got that. So 3 twelfths is not big enough to subtract 4 twelfths. So we're going to take the 1 and think of it as 12 twelfths. So 12 twelfths plus 3 twelfths equals 15 twelfths. And now we can subtract. 15 twelfths minus 4 twelfths is equal to 11 twelfths. And that is the exact same answer we've got here. All right. Now, we could think of that as on the number line. We could think of that as, so, and I'm going to zoom in again. So what we did is we started at 3 1/4, and then we went backwards by 2, because we subtracted 2. And that gave us 1 1/4. Then, once we did that, we needed to subtract 1/3. So then we subtracted 1/3. All right? And that's essentially what the and then the question mark would go right here. That's our answer, right there. So that's what it would look like on the number line, if we were going to use a number line. And then I do want to show you one more way, and this is like your Duane Habecker bonus, because this is not in Engage New York. This is called the empty number line. So it takes advantage of the fact that addition and subtraction are related. So this problem here means if we thought about the number line, on the number line somewhere 2 1/3 would be here, and somewhere to the right, it doesn't matter exactly where, 3 1/4 would be way over here. Now, subtraction means how far is it from here to here, all right? And so we're going to figure out through a variety of small steps, and there's more than one way to get this answer as well, how far the distance is from here up to here. What do we have to add to 2 1/3 to get to 3 1/4? And so, one way to do it, it's not the only way, I'm going to bump us up to the next whole number. I want to get to the next whole number, which is 3. And the way I do that is I would add 2/3. Because 2 1/3 plus 2/3 bumps me up to 3. And then, what do I need to go, what do I need to add to go from 3 to 3 1/4? So I would need to add 1/4. And so my answer to this question up here is whatever the heck 2/3 plus 1/4 is. So I would need to add 2/3 plus 1/4. And in this case, of course, the common denominator is 12. 3 times 4 is 12, so 2 times 4 is 8. 4 times 3 is 12. So 1 times 3 is 3. And then we add those together, and we get 11 twelfths. All right. So this method here is called the empty number line method, and it's really famous in Australia, in England, northern European countries. I like it. Now, you'll notice I didn't draw this proportional. I'm not trying to make it look proportional. I'm just using this number line to visualize what's going on. Lots of ways to solve this problem, but the video is going to be long, so I'm going to make this one quick. I'll solve it twice, once using kind of a traditional method, and then once using the empty number line method, which is not actually part of the engage thing. So let's start with 8 and 2/3 minus 3 and 5/7. And our common denominator, our common unit, is 21. So we know we're going to rename both of these fractions so they have 21 as their denominator. So how do you turn thirds into 21sts? Times by 7, which means you times the 2 by 7, and you get 14. And then, how do you turn sevenths into 21ths, or 21sts? You multiply by 3, which means we multiply the numerator by 3, which gives us 15. And now, there's a couple of ways we could do this. I think I'll do my favorite way, I think. So 8 minus 3 gives us 5. So that's 5 and 14 21sts minus 15 21sts. And I think what I'll do is I'll turn this 5. I'm going to subtract the 5 and the 15 21sts. You may have to pause the video to catch up with me on this, but if I subtract 15 21sts, that's going to give me 4 and 6 21sts. And now we have to add in the portion of the fraction that we kind of ignored for a second there. It's 14 over 21, and 4 and 6 21sts plus 14 21sts gives us 4 and 20 21sts. So there's our answer, 4 and 20 21sts. So if we were going to use the empty number line, which is not exactly in the Engage New York module, but I'm going to give it to you anyway because I like this method. So we've got 8 and 2/3 is somewhere on the number line. And then we have 3 and 5/7 somewhere on the number line. And we want to figure, what do we have to add to 3 and 5/7 to boost ourselves all the way up to 8 and 2/3? So a couple of ways we could do this. One, I like to bump us up to the next whole number. So what's the next whole number? Well, the next whole number is 4. So what do we have to add to get to 4? Well, we're going to add 2/7. And then, to go from here to, let's go to 8. So we're not quite up to 8 and 2/3. Well, to go from 4 to 8, we're going to add 4. And then, to go from 8 to 8 and 2/3, that means we need to add by 2/3. By the way, this is not the only way to hop and figure out how to go from 3 and 5/7 up to 8 and 2/3. There's other ways. So now we're going to add these three numbers up here. So I'm going to take the 4 and add it to the 2/7. So that immediately gives us 4 and 2/7 plus 2/3. Now we're going to get our common denominator. In this case, it's 21. So 7 times 3 is 21 as our denominator. So 2 times 3 is 6 as our numerator. And our denominator down here, 3 times 7 is 21. So our numerator is multiplied by 7, and we get 14. And so now we can add them together, and we get 4 and 20 21sts. Same answer as the other one, just a different way of doing it. Now, teachers, our idea is we don't want to reduce all this stuff to just a bunch of rules for our students to follow. We really want to teach for understanding. So make sure you give plenty of opportunity for students to talk about a problem and maybe solve that one problem in a variety of different ways so they can really get to the heart of the mathematics and develop number sense. In this word problem, I'm not going to solve it. I'm just going to show you how to draw the tape diagram. It doesn't say we have to draw a tape diagram, but I'm going to do it anyway. So Ms. Sanger blended 8 3/4 gallons of iced tea with some lemonade, we don't know how much, and there were 13 2/5 gallons in the mixture total. So the question is, how many gallons of lemonade did she use? So basically, we've got some iced tea, iced tea, and then we've got some lemonade. Oops, gee whiz. Lemonade. There we go. And we know that there was 8 3/4 gallons of iced tea. We don't know how much lemonade there was because it says some lemonade. But we do know that the total is 13 2/5. So the way we're going to find our answer for the lemonade is through subtraction. And it's going to be 13 2/5 minus 8 3/4. Whew, that was a long video. Thank you for being patient. That's 5th grade, Module 3, Lesson 12.